Today's class, we are going to start a new topic called as continuity and differentiability. I think this is the topic in continuation with our 11th class, a chapter known as limits. If you could observe carefully, a function is said to have a limit L. A function is said to have a limit L, provided both left hand limit and right hand limit should be equal. Now, when coming to the continuity, there we had not defined about the value, but here we'll be defining about limit of a function, and if limit of a function is existing, it should be equal to the value of a function. Before taking up the definition, I would like to give a small example. This is a straight line passing through a region, and it is given as y equal to x, and this is given as y equal to minus x. Here function I go like this, I define like this, y is equal to f of x is equal to x if x is greater than 0, that is equal to minus x if x is less than 0, that is equal to 0 if x is equal to 0. If you could observe carefully, when x is greater than 0, what is happening? Function or y equal to x we are getting. Like this I am drawing. And when y is equal to minus x, I am drawing like this. That means never I lifted the pen means I have never got a gap while drawing this particular diagram. So, if we are not able to lift the pen, or if we are not able to get any kind of gap while drawing a curve, then we can tell that particular function is continuous. Mathematically, how can I tell means a function f of x is said to be continuous at x is equal to a if limit extends to a f of x is equal to f of a. That means limit of a function should exist, and if it is existing, it should be equal to f of a. This particular f of a we call it as a value of a function. In general, still how can I tell means a function is said to be continuous if left hand limit means we have already learned in our 11th class, limit extends to a minus f of x should be equal to limit extends to a plus f of x should be equal to f of a. That means a function is said to be continuous if and only if at x is equal to a, limit extends to a, f of x should be equal to f of a. One thing you should remember, if left hand limit is not equal to right hand limit, then also we can tell the function is not continuous. If limit is existing, and if suppose it is not equal to the value of a function, then also we can tell the function is not continuous. That means, in general, what can I tell? If suppose a problem is given to us, show that the function is continuous. What we need to show? We need to show limit extends to a, f of x should be equal to f of a. That means LHS should get exist means what? Left hand limit should be equal to right hand limit if this is existing, and all these values should be equal to f of a. So two things you should remember, friends. Graphically, when you draw a curve, you should not lift the pen. That means the curve should go on. The best example I can tell means, if suppose y equal to x square I will be taking, or some curve, right? This is continuous. Suppose sine x curve I will be taking. This is also continuous. This one we call as what curve? Sin x. And this is y equal to x cube, right? And this is y equal to mod x. Earlier also x, and all these curves are continuous. That means if we are not able to lift the pen while drawing a graph, then we can tell that particular function is continuous. Mathematically, how we should show? Limit extends to a, f of x should be equal to f of a, right? Now we shall start our problems, right? A problem might be given to us like this. Test the continuity of the function f of x at x is equal to 0, where f of x is equal to e power 1 by x by 1 plus e power 1 by x if x is not equal to 0 and that is equal to 0 when x is equal to 0. So here what I'll be doing means, given f of x is equal to e power 1 by x by 1 plus e power 1 by x when x is not equal to 0 and that is defined as 0 when x is equal to 0. Now first what I'll be doing means, I'll be finding out the left hand limit. Left hand limit at x is equal to 0, that means it is denoted by limit extends to 0 minus f of x. So what happens? Limit extends to 0 minus f of x means e power 1 by x plus 1 by e power 1 by x. So if you could observe carefully, I will write like this, limit h tends to 0, this can be written as e power minus 1 by h plus 1 plus e power minus 1 by h. Now here again what happens, if you could observe carefully, limit extends to 0 minus e power 1 by x plus e power 1 by x can be written as limit h tends to 0 e power minus 1 by h plus 1 plus e power minus 1 by h. This how you got this particular thing, we explained in our 11th class. But now if you could observe carefully, e power minus 1 by h can be written as 1 by e power 1 by h. When I apply limit, what happens? Limit h tends to 0, 1 by e power 1 by h. That means limit h tends to 0, 1 by e power 1 by h means 1 by h, h ki sthan mein 0 substitute. If we substitute h ki place mein 0, then what happens? Limit h tends to 0, 1 by e power 1 by h. So it becomes 1 by infinity. 1 by infinity means finally it becomes 0. So what happens here also, when limit h is tending to 0, our numerator will become 0 and the denominator here this place e power minus 1 by h becomes 0. So what happens? 0 by 1 plus 0, that is equal to 0. So left hand limit we got as 0. Now after finding the left hand limit, we need to evaluate our right hand limit. So right hand limit here I am keeping heading. So what happens again? Limit extends to 0 plus f of x. So what happens? Limit extends to 0 plus means again limit extends to 0 limit extends to 0 plus e power 1 by x by 1 plus e power 1 by x. So again here I am writing, this can be rewritten as limit h tends to 0 e power 1 by h by 1 plus e power 1 by h, but as h is tending to 0, so it is becoming like infinity by infinity. Whenever infinity by infinity is getting, I said in our earlier classes, in limits classes, we need to take the highest thing or highest power thing common in numerator and denominator, and we need to cancel those particular terms. Here what I'll be doing means, limit h tends to 0 e power 1 by h, I will take a common from numerator as well as from denominator. So this turns down to 1 plus e power minus 1 by h and both will be getting cancelled. And after both getting cancelled, numerator will become 1, and after applying the limit, our denominator becomes 1 upon 1 plus 0. So this becomes as 1. That means left hand limit I got as 0 and right hand limit I got as 1. And here I am writing clearly left hand limit LHL is not equal to right hand limit. That means limit does not exist, limit does not exist, limit does not exist means the function is not continuous. The function is not continuous means what can I tell? It is a discontinuous function at x is equal to 0. Discontinuous at x is equal to 0. It's an important pattern. Like this problems you will be getting for 4 marks in CBSE questions. Now we shall go for another numerical.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.